Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free clip from my larger Microsoft Word training course. Check out the link in the description or go to bringyourownlaptop.com for more. Hello, lovely people. In this tutorial, we're going to look at making this red box column thing that sits over here, okay, with a bunch of text, red fill. Let's go and make this. It's called a text box. All right, so first thing we need to do is we need to be conscious of where we have our cursor flashing, because that's where it's going to kind of be anchored to. So it doesn't really matter. I'm going to put mine at the beginning of my title and we'll look at it with a bit more detail afterwards. Okay, so cursor's there. I'm going to go to the insert. Okay, you might be at home, go to insert, and then we're going to find one called text box. There it is there. Okay. Couple of different options, we're just going to put in the simple text box, and it kind of goes in line, which is a bit weird. It kind of goes in and just kind of gets all jammed in there. So next thing we need to do, under too much, there he is there. Okay, and what we're going to do is with them selected, there's this little flyout option here, okay, and it's called layout options. So you got to click the edge, click on this, and then we're going to use this one that says the one that says text behind. It just means it's kind of detached from the flow of text and I can move them around. So now I can grab this edge, go up to here, kind of line him up with this. I'm gonna drag him down so he fits in there. And I'm gonna maybe move him in just a tiny bit now. Lovely. You can use your arrow keys. Can you see on my keyboard? Well, you can't see, okay, but tap, tap, tap on my keyboard. We're gonna do a couple of things now. I wanna remove the border and give it a big background color and play with this padding. So let's do that now. So the first thing we need to do is with it selected, okay, grab the edge of it. You might be still on home. Can you see there's this option that says format? That thing there only appears when you have the text box selected, which is it disappears. So grab the edge. It's contextual, okay? It means that it's optional on what I've got selected. So you can see a bunch of different stuff. There's some presets, okay? Colored presets, okay? There's some text styles, okay? Terrible, I'm undoing. So what I want to do though is shape fill. I want to pick my corporate color. If you haven't, you can pick any color here. You can add more colors, pick them from here or type them in if you know the RGB value. But I've got ones, I've set the defaults to that red. And where it says outline, okay, I'm gonna go to no outline, so there's no line around the outside. Next thing I wanna do is I wanna push the padding away. It's a bit too close to the edge here. So with it selected, okay, I'll grab the outside of it and go up to here where it says shape styles. There's all sorts of shape styles, but can you see this little flyout menu? These are really important, okay? They don't look very exciting, but these little things, so it's showing you some information. If you pop that out, it gives you a lot more, okay? And in our case, we wanna play around with this last one here. It says layout and properties. We're gonna go to text box even, and there's our margins. And you can just keep adjusting these depending on what you wanna do. Now, I've pre-written mine out, so I know what I wanna do. The problem is I've written them down in points because I was designing this stuff on a different computer. Now, let's say that you've got them, it's moment my computer said to inches, great. If you have got millimeters though, or in my case, I've used points to style these, is you can go in here and just select them and actually just type in points and it will convert them for you. It's a cool little extra feature. So I wanted 24, you can see inches, this is gonna be too big, but if I put PT afterwards, you can see it's converted it. And if I tab down to the next one, it's 0.33 inches, nice. Okay, so you can type in anything. If I want 5 millimeters, it will convert it for me as well. So the left and the right are gonna be the same. So I know it's 0.33. And the top, I can't remember what was mine. I had 40 for the top. PT, and the bottom I'll do 40 as well, 40 PT. Great little conversion. Now, any text box that you see anywhere in Word, okay, over here, you can type these in and it will convert it for you without having to do anything. So that's how to adjust the padding. Okay, we've done the color, let's do the fonts that go inside this thing now. So what I'm gonna use is I'm gonna grab this bit here. These are the bits of text that I'm gonna use. I'm gonna cut them out. So edit cut, there's this option up here. Sorry, not edit cuts, it's just click this cut button or control X. I'm gonna select this text, delete it, paste this in here. So now I'm gonna do some basic formatting, just select all the text. I'm going to go and pick you, Arial, it's gonna be 10 points. No, it's gonna be bigger, it's gonna be 14. Calm down, Dan. Okay, and it's going to be bold and it's going to be white. Okay, and what I wanna do is put a return in. I'm gonna grab page 2 and say, actually, where did my white go? Anyway, I'm gonna put in 10. I'd like all you guys to be white. Great. And what I'd like to do as well is I'd like to remove the spacing between the two. Okay, it's called space after. So with this selected here, I can go to my little drop down, okay, and go to remove space after. So it kind of jams up next to it. And what I'd like to do is maybe a line underneath, okay, a bit of a horizontal rule. So I'm going to put a return in because there's a gap between the two, and I want to put a horizontal rule. To put a horizontal ruler in, okay, that goes to the edge, is it's under this border. So I'm in the home, there's this little icon, and there's a bunch of different stuff, okay, and the one you want is horizontal line, okay. And by default, I don't know why Word likes to put like a bit of a drop shadow underneath it. It takes the font color, so it's white. But if I double click it, okay, I can get into some adjustments for it, and I definitely don't want it to have the shady background. Okay, I want to use a solid color, which is great. You can play with how tall it is, okay, how thick the line is, yeah, and a bunch of different stuff. So I'm gonna click okay, that's what I want. Great. Now, in terms of the color, I've got to double click it again, and there's the color here. White. Nice. I said it takes the font color. I lied. So, that's that guy. I'm gonna put in. So I've got that. I've got the line. What I might do for this one as well is there a space after? Okay, between the line and after page two. So with it selected, I'm gonna go to this. I'm gonna say remove space after. Nice. Cool. So the next bit's gonna be stepping repeating. So could be a little boring if you wanna skip to the end and skip to the next tutorial. Go and do that. If you wanna follow me along, I'm gonna put some returns in after these pages. Yep. And I'm going to grab this horizontal rule, select it, copy it, paste it underneath these, underneath you, underneath you, underneath you. Great. And I want to match the size and the space before of these things. So a couple of things we need to do. Well, we'll look at the format painter. We're going to look at it in a bit more detail later on, but basically it's this. Select the text you'd like. Hit Format Painter, paint it on the things to change them. Okay, currently selected. Here we go. Okay, same with this. Okay, that's the one I like with the space after gone. Does the Format Painter pick it up? It does. Great. We could set up styles, and we're gonna look at styles in a little bit. So you definitely want to do that, especially this is not too long, okay. There's not too many things going on, so would a style be helpful? It'll probably take you just as long to do what we just did. One of the things we're gonna do is there's a nice big gap at the top, but this guy here is at the top is quite jammed in, so I want the space in here, and you could totally just do return. Okay, and yeah, nobody's gonna find you. I'll find you. Okay, you're not doing it properly. But the proper ways, we've done space after, we can do space before as well. So with your cursor anywhere in this heading here, I can say, where is he? This one here, got a line spacing. There's one called space before. So how much do I want? Maybe 20 points, I think. Yeah, just gives a nice space there. So what I can do now is use my format paint. I should have totally done this before I put the space before and before I did the first bit of content format painter. Now, a cool little shortcut as we can do is we can do Control Shift C. So Control Shift C will kind of copy the format, and then I can select this and go Control Shift V. Okay, highlight you, Control Shift V, Control Shift V. All right, so that's the formatting of this red box on the side here. It's a text box, it can be moved. We've got some padding going on. We've looked at format painting a little bit, space before, and horizontal rule. All right, let's get on to our next video. How'd you find that video? Was it good? Was it bad? If you liked it, go check out more of my courses on bringyourownlaptop.com.